JFT, just fair and direct.
Good morning, everyone, and welcome to JFD's daily market review for January the 28th. I am Charalambos Pissouros, senior market analyst here at JFD, and I will talk about yesterday's main market movers, what's my opinion moving ahead, what are today's important events, and how they could affect the markets. But before we start, let's read our disclaimer. The content we produce does not constitute investment advice or investment recommendation, should not be considered as such, and does not in any way constitute an invitation to acquire any financial instrument or product. I will leave you a few seconds to read the rest, and then we will jump into our analysis. Okay, the US dollar traded higher against all the other G10 currencies on Wednesday and during the Asian session Thursday. It gained the most versus NOK, Aussie and Kiwi in that order, while it outperformed the least against the Swiss franc, the British pound, the euro and the Japanese yen. The relative strength of the US dollar, the Swiss franc and the Japanese yen, combined with the weakening of the risk-linked Aussie and Kiwi, suggests that markets traded in a risk-off manner yesterday and today in Asia. Indeed, turning our gaze to the equity world, we see that EU and US indices were a sea of red, with Wall Street suffering the most in 3 months. The risk aversion rolled over into the Asian session today, with Japan's Nikkei and China Shanghai composite falling 1.53 and 1.91% respectively. There was no clear catalyst behind the tumble in equities, but market chatter suggests that it may have been due to hedge funds with short positions in GameStop and other meme stocks closing long positions in other stocks to cover their losses following the frenzy rally in the former group. The slowdown in the COVID vaccinations rollout in Europe and the US may have also weighed on market sentiment. On top of that, Wall Street accelerated its tumble following the FOMC decision. The Fed decided to keep its monetary policy settings unchanged, with the only material change in the statement being the part saying that the pace of the recovery in economic activity and employment has moderated in recent months. Although at the press conference following the decision, Fed Chair Powell clearly stated that it's too early to focus on tapering dates, it seems that investors paid more attention to the concerns over the economic recovery. As for our view, we still believe that the bigger picture of equities remains positive. Yes, the current retreat may continue for a while more, but we would treat this as a corrective phase. The GameStop phenomenon will likely prove to be temporary, while with regards to the coronavirus, we still believe that the worst is behind us. Even at a slower than expected pace, the vaccinations around the globe continue, something that may eventually allow lockdown measures to be lifted and thereby let the global economy to recover. The extra loose monetary policy worldwide and a large fiscal spending package in the US may also help market sentiment to improve. Now, as for today's events, we get the German preliminary inflation data for January and the first estimate of the US GDP for the fourth quarter. Both the German CPI and the HICP rates are expected to have rebounded to 0.7% year-over-year and 0.5% year-over-year from minus 0.3% and minus 0.7% respectively. This could raise speculation that Eurozone's headline inflation may also exit the negative territory. As for the US GDP, following the 31.4% quarter-over-quarter seasonally adjusted rate tumble in the second quarter, it rebounded 33.4% in the third quarter, and now it is expected to normalize at around 4% in the last quarter of 2020. The US new home sales for December and the initial jobless claims for last week are also coming out. New home sales are expected to have rebounded 1.5% month over month, after an 11% slide in November, while jobless claims are anticipated to have declined somewhat to 875,000 from 900,000. As for tonight, during the Asian session Friday, we get the usual end-of-month data dump from Japan. The unemployment rate is forecast to have ticked up to 3% from 2.9%, while the jobs to applications ratio is expected to have held steady at 1.06. The Tokyo core CPI is anticipated to have increased to minus 0.6% year over year from minus 0.9%, while no forecast is available for the headline print. Japan's preliminary industrial production for December is expected to have fallen 1.5% month over month after sliding 0.5% in November. The summary of opinions from last week's Bank of Japan monetary policy meeting is also coming out. We also have one speaker on today's agenda, and this is ECB Executive Board member Isabel Schnabel. So that's it from me. Thank you very much for watching and listening. For those who are interested in learning about the main events of the week much earlier, you can subscribe to the weekly Market Outlook webinar, which I'm holding every Monday at 8 o'clock AM GMT. You can find the link in the description below. So goodbye, have a great day, and I'm looking forward to seeing you here again tomorrow.
JFT, just fair and direct.